ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
నెక్స్ట్ ప్రిపరేషన్ మెథడ్ ఈస్ ఆక్సిడేషన్ ఆఫ్ సెకండరీ ఆల్కహాల్స్, దట్ ఈస్ ఓపెన్ ఆర్ ఆక్సిడేషన్. Open R oxidation. Open R oxidation, or it is also called as MPVR, Mirvin Pondorf Verrilli reduction reaction. MPVR reduction, open R oxidation, or Mirvin Pondorf Verrilli reduction reaction. Secondary alcohols in the presence of aluminium isopropoxide, aluminium isopropoxide to form ketones. This is open R oxidation, secondary alcohols to ketone in the presence of aluminium isopropoxide. Aluminium isopropoxide. Secondary alcohol is CH3, CHOH and CH3. This is secondary alcohol, or it is also called as isopropyl alcohol. It is a secondary alcohol. In the presence of aluminium isopropoxide, aluminium isopropoxide, the secondary alcohol is converted into ketone CH3 C double bond O CH3. This is ketone. Okay, forward reaction is secondary alcohols to ketone. What is the difference here? CH3 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 common. Here C double bond O, here removal of hydrogens. C double bond O, here CHOH. Alcohol group is converted into ketone. Here removal of hydrogens. Forward reaction is removal of hydrogen. Removal of hydrogen is nothing but oxidation reaction. So therefore, your forward reaction is oxidation reaction. So that is open R oxidation. Open R oxidation. Open R oxidation reaction. Open R oxidation. Now, backward reaction, product to reactant. Backward reaction, a C double bond O group is present. Keto group is reduced to secondary alcohol. Means in backward reaction, addition of hydrogens. Addition of hydrogens is nothing but reduction. Okay, your backward reaction is, this is forward reaction, and backward reaction is, it is oxidation. Forward reaction is oxidation, that is called open R oxidation, and backward reaction is reduction reaction. This is called as Mirvin Pondorf Verrilli reduction reaction. So this is called as MPVR, Mirvin Pondorf Verrilli reduction. This is open R oxidation. So forward reaction is open R oxidation, backward reaction is Mirvin Pondorf Verrilli reduction reaction. In this reaction, both oxidation and reduction reactions are simultaneously takes place. Hence, this reaction is best example for redox reaction. Okay, it is a redox reaction. redox reaction. Why it is called as redox reaction? In this reaction, simultaneously both oxidation as well as reduction reactions are takes place. Hence, this reaction is called as redox reaction. Forward reaction is the oxidation, backward reaction is the reduction. So, forward oxidation reaction is called as Wappenaar oxidation. Backward reduction reaction is called as MPVR reduction, here preparation of ketone from secondary alkyls. This is Wappenaar oxidation. Right, then go for next one is pyrolysis of carboxylic acids. Pyrolysis of carboxylic acids. Pyrolysis of carboxylic acids. Pyrolysis of carboxylic acids. In this case, calcium formate HCOO taken twice Ca. Calcium formate on pyrolysis. This is called as calcium formate. Okay, calcium formate pyrolysis, it gives formaldehyde formation and byproduct is calcium carbonate. Okay, how to write the product here? Calcium formate is like this, HCOO, here calcium, oxygen, C double bond OH. This is calcium formate. In this calcium carbonate, calcium formate, removal of calcium carbonate, CaCO3, remaining HCOH. This is formaldehyde. Okay, formaldehyde and calcium carbonate, aldehyde formation. Similarly, calcium acetate, CH3COO taken twice Ca. Calcium acetate upon pyrolysis, upon pyrolysis reaction, it gives acetone formation or dimethyl ketone, CH3COCH3 and calcium carbonate. This is called as ketone. Okay, it is formaldehyde formation. Okay, aldehydes and ketones are prepared by using pyrolysis of carboxylic acids. If you take mixture, calcium formate and calcium acetate is taken, what happen here? HCOO taken twice Ca, calcium formate, and calcium acetate CH3COO taken twice Ca, calcium formate and calcium acetate upon pyrolysis, what happen here? CH3CH4, from this aldehyde group, from this CH3CO group, so acetaldehyde formation, major product is acetaldehyde CH3CH4, and another one is acetone CH3C double bond O, and one more crossed product, that is formaldehyde. In this, acetaldehyde is the major product and these two are minor products. Okay, this is the preparation method of aldehydes and ketones by using pyrolysis. Okay, its name is calcium acetate. It is a calcium acetate, calcium acetate. Calcium formate pyrolysis, formaldehyde formation. Calcium acetate pyrolysis, ketone formation. If both are taken, mixed product is obtained, aldehyde, ketone and formaldehyde is obtained. Among these three products, major is acetaldehyde. Crossed product is the major. Yes. Then go for next one. Hydrolysis of geminal dihalides. Okay. Hydrolysis of geminal dihalides. Hydrolysis of gem dihalides. Hydrolysis of gem dihalides. Okay, geminal and vicinal. Geminal means here gem. Geminal means two halogens present on the same carbon atom is geminal. Two halogens present on same carbon. Halogens means fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Two halogens present on the same carbon, that is geminal. And vicinal, geminal and vicinal. Okay, here geminal dihalide, this one. Vicinal means two halogens are present on the adjacent carbons. Two halogens present on the adjacent carbon is called as vicinal. Geminal dihalides and vicinal dihalides. Geminal means two halogens are present on the same carbon. Vicinal, two halogens present on the adjacent carbon atoms is nothing but vicinal. Now here aldehydes and ketones are prepared by using geminal dihalides. Geminal dihalides. Example, CH3, here chlorine, hydrogen and chlorine. Two chlorines are present on the same carbon, so therefore this is geminal dihalide. 1,1 dichloroethane, geminal dihalide. Geminal dihalide on treatment with aqueous NaOH. Or hydrolysis, normal hydrolysis or aqueous NaOH, here chlorine is replaced by OH group. So here CH3COH, here OH group and hydrogen. This is diol. Okay, diol is less stable compound, therefore immediately it is undergoes dehydration reaction, removal of water. Removal of water, finally we are getting aldehyde, CH3, C double bond O, H. This is aldehyde formation, acetaldehyde formation. Okay, so geminal dihalides upon hydrolysis to produce aldehydes, that is acetaldehyde. Similarly, and one more example is taken, CH3 carbon and CH3 here chlorine and chlorine. Two chlorines are present on the same carbon. This is also geminal, geminal dihalide. Two halogens present on same carbon, geminal. Here also two halogens present on the same carbon, geminal. So here middle geminal carbon, here terminal geminal carbon. So middle geminal carbon hydrolyzed with aqueous NaOH. These two chlorines replaced by two OH groups. So CH3 carbon and OH, here OH group and CH3. It is also diol. Only one carbon possesses two functional groups, two OH groups. Therefore, it is less stable. Immediately, it is undergoes dehydration reaction. So therefore, it is undergoes dehydration, removal of water to form ketone, CH3CO, CH3, it is a ketone, dimethyl ketone or acetone or propanone. Okay, so geminal dihalides upon hydrolysis, aldehydes, Geminal dialates upon hydrolysis ketones. Both aldehydes and ketones are prepared by using hydrolysis of geminal dihalates. Yes, and one more method is Rosenmund reduction reaction. And one more preparation method. Rosenmund reduction reaction. Rosenmund reduction. Rosenmund reduction reaction. A Rosenmund reduction reaction is acid halides reaction with palladium barium sulfate by hydrogenation. These are produces aldehydes only. Okay, acid halides reduction with palladium barium sulfate is called as Rosenmund reduction. In this method, we can prepare only aldehydes but not ketones. Ketones cannot be prepared by using Rosenmund reduction. Only we can prepare aldehydes. Yes, here acid halide. Acid halide is RCOCl, acid chloride. Now this acid chloride reacts with palladium barium sulfate and hydrogen. This hydrogen is attached to the carbon and one more hydrogen with chlorine HCl formation. It is produced by aldehyde. Here CHO group is nothing but aldehyde. For example, if you take acetyl chloride, CH3COCl, acetyl chloride, on treatment with palladium barium sulfate reduction H2, it gives acetaldehyde formation, CH3CHO, acetaldehyde. Similarly, if you take benzyl chloride, C6H5COCl, benzyl chloride is taken in the presence of palladium barium sulfate and hydrogen, this benzyl chloride is converted into benzaldehyde, C6H5CHO. Its name is benzaldehyde, benzaldehyde formation. It is a benzyl chloride, benzyl chloride. This is acetyl chloride, acetyl chloride. So acid chlorides on treatment with palladium and barium sulfate to produce aldehydes. So in this method only aldehydes are prepared but not ketones. This is Rosenmund reduction. And next one is Samlet reaction. Next one is Samlet reaction. Samlet reaction. Your Samlet reaction is benzyl chloride reacts with hexamethylene tetraamine. hexamethylene tetraamine. This is also called as urotropin. Urotropin, hexamethylene tetraamine or urotropin, and followed by hydrolysis to form benzaldehyde formation. Aromatic aldehydes are prepared by using Somlet reaction. Okay, benzyl chloride is C6H5, here CH2Cl. This is benzyl chloride. Hexamethylene tetraamine, CH2 taken 6 hexamethylene, here N for tetraamine. Hexamethylene tetraamine, it gives the intermediate compound, that is benzene with CH2 and CH2 taken 6 N4 plus Cl minus. So upon hydrolysis, this intermediate compound upon hydrolysis to produce aldehyde formation. This is benzaldehyde formation. This reaction is called as Somlet reaction. Okay, what is Somlet reaction? Benzyl chloride on treatment with hexamethylene tetraamine to form an intermediate compound. This intermediate compound on hydrolysis to produce benzaldehyde formation. This reaction is known as Somlet reaction. Okay, Somlet reaction. Right, then go for, and one more preparation method, Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. Okay, Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. And one more method, Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. Friedel-Crafts acylation. Okay, already you know this reaction. It is in first year organic chemistry. Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. Benzene on treatment with acetyl chloride, CH3COCl, in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3, aluminum chloride, Lewis acid. Benzene reacts with acetyl chloride in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3, it gives acetophenol, C6H5COCH3. Its name is acetophenol formation. It is a ketone. In Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction, we can prepare only aromatic ketones, C double bond O group. Benzene reacts with acetyl chloride in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3, it gives acetophenol. This is Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. And one more reaction, Gutterman reaction. Gutterman formylation reaction. Yes, benzene reacts with CO plus HCl, CO plus HCl in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3. A formyl group is attached to the benzene, it forms benzaldehyde formation. Okay, how it is possible? Here CO plus HCl gives rise to HCOCl, formyl chloride. Formyl chloride, removal of chlorine, it gives HCO plus. Okay, this HCO plus reacts with benzene ring, it produces benzaldehyde, CHO, benzaldehyde formation. This reaction is called as Gutterman formylation reaction. Benzene with CO plus HCl in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3, it gives benzaldehyde. This is Gutterman formylation reaction. Yes, and one more reaction is Gutterman aldehyde synthesis is also same. Instead of CO, we can take HCl. Gutterman aldehyde synthesis. Yes, then go for, and one more important one is from Grignard reagent. Preparation of aldehydes and ketones from Grignard, from Grignard reagent. Okay, what is Grignard reagent? Alkyl magnesium halide, RMGX. Alkyl magnesium halide is called as Grignard reagent. Now, by using this Grignard reagent, we can prepare aldehydes and also ketones. For example, Grignard reagent plus hydrogen cyanide and followed by hydrolysis, aldehydes are obtained. If Grignard reagent plus any alkyl cyanide hydrolysis, H3O plus ketones formation. Or Grignard reagent plus acid chlorides RCOCl, here also same ketones formation. Okay, reaction with Grignard reagent. Grignard reagent plus hydrogen cyanide, aldehyde formation. Grignard reagent with alkyl cyanide, ketone formation. Grignard reagent with acid chloride, ketone formation. Yes, first example, example 1. Grignard reagent is CH3MgCl, methyl magnesium chloride, Grignard reagent. It is reacts with hydrogen cyanide, HCl. Hydrogen cyanide. Okay, what happened here? The CH3 group is attached to the carbon. As a result, 5 bonded electrons shift towards nitrogen. So this nitrogen is attached to magnesium, Mg. As a result, it gives CH3 group is attached to carbon. So CH3 carbon, carbon with hydrogen, triple bond becomes double bond, N. Here MgCl. Now this intermediate compound upon hydrolysis H2O. What happened here? Breakage of the bond. This oxygen atom is attached to carbon. It gives CH3CH here double bond O. Remaining byproduct is NH2MgCl. This is called as aldehyde. Okay, aldehyde formation. CH3CHO aldehyde. Grignard reagent, hydrogen cyanide, HCl, hydrogen cyanide. Okay, Grignard reagent on treatment with hydrogen cyanide to form an intermediate compound. This intermediate compound further hydrolysis, finally we are getting aldehydes. And one more example, Grignard reagent with alkyl cyanide. Example 2, Grignard reagent is methyl magnesium chloride, reacts with methyl cyanide, any alkyl cyanide, gives rise to, yeah, this methyl group is attached to triple bonded carbon, pi bonded electron shift towards more electronegative nitrogen, and this nitrogen is attached to magnesium. It gives CH3 carbon, here CH3 double bond N MgCl. Upon hydrolysis, breakage of the bond, oxygen atom attached to carbon, it becomes ketone. CH3CO CH3 ketone formation, plus similarly NH2MgCl. This is a ketone. Preparation of aldehydes and next one is ozonolysis reaction. Next method is from alkenes. From alkenes, ozonolysis reaction. Yes, here alkene CH2 double bond CH2 alkene on treatment with ozone O3. Okay, it gives CH2 oxygen malazonide upon hydrolysis in the presence of zinc. What happen? Bond breakage takes place in the presence of zinc and water, H2O2, here formaldehyde and formaldehyde. So 2 moles of HCH4. CH2O means formaldehyde, 2 moles formaldehyde plus hydrogen peroxide H2O2. Here aldehydes preparation. And one more example is CH3CH double bond CH2 alkene, here ozone in the presence of zinc and water, breakage of the bond. Here two oxygens are added to double bonded carbon, it becomes CH3CHO. Next, formaldehyde CH2O. Okay, what is the trick to write the product from reactants? Simply, breakage of the double bond, addition of two oxygens, then we are getting products. How to write the product to reactant? Removal of oxygens and kept the double bond between the two carbons is reactants. Okay, acetaldehyde and formaldehyde. For example, if you take substituted alkene CH3CH like this, it is reacts with ozone in the presence of zinc and water. What happen here? Double bond breakage of the double bond, addition of two oxygens, CH3CO CH3 ketone formation, CH3C double bond O CH3, this is ketone. Next, CH3CHO aldehyde formation. Okay, so breakage of the double bond, addition of two oxygens, we are getting the product. So olefins or alkenes on ozonolysis reaction, we are getting carbonyl compounds like aldehydes and ketones. Okay, this is ozonolysis reaction. And one more reaction is oxo process. Preparation of aldehydes by using oxo process. Oxo process or CH double bond CH2 alkenes on treatment with CO plus H2 is called as water gas or syngas, or it is also called as synthesis gas, or it is also known as blue gas. Okay, olefins on treatment with CO plus H2, it gives R. Here H group is attached to the middle carbon, CH2. Next, the CH2 group is attached to formyl, CH2 and CHO. This is aldehyde formation. Okay, in oxo process, alkenes reacts with CO plus H2 in the presence of carbonyls, tetracarbonyls, to produce aldehydes. Okay, aldehyde formation by using oxo process. Further reduction of aldehydes, it is produced by long chain alcohols. Okay, here further reduction, long chain alcohols, reduction, long chain alcohols. Further reduction, long chain alcohols are obtained. Long chain alcohols obtained. These long chain alcohols are used in the preparation of detergents. Detergents and also soaps. Long chain alcohols are used in the preparation of detergents and soaps. But majorly here, this is enough to prepare aldehydes. Oxo process is also helpful to prepare aldehydes. Yes, then go for next method is from nitriles. From nitriles and esters. This is important method. From nitriles and esters. From nitriles and esters. Yes, here R C triple bond N. Nitrile means cyanide. On treatment with SnCl2 plus HCl and followed by hydrolysis, aldehyde formation, RCHO. Similarly, the cyanides on treatment with dibol H, diisobutyl aluminium hydride. Diisobutyl aluminium hydride, it is also produces aldehyde, RCHO. If we are using SnCl2 and HCl, this reaction is called as Stepan's reaction. So, CH3C triple bond N, methyl cyanide, reacts with SnCl2 plus HCl, and it is reduced to RCH, means CH3CH double bond NH. And further hydrolysis, it gives acetaldehyde, CH3CHO, acetaldehyde plus ammonia. So, cyanides are converted into aldehydes. This reaction is called as Stepan's reaction. This reaction is known as Stepan's reaction. Stepan's reaction. Similarly, here dibol H is also used for the conversion of cyanides to aldehydes. So here CH3 C triple bond N or like this CH3 CH double bond CH, here CH2 C triple bond N, here cyanide group and olefinic group is present. This is most important one. Olefinic part and cyanide group is there. It is on treatment with dibol H, diisobutyl aluminium hydride. Only it is reduces cyanide to aldehyde, but not olefins. Olefins retain same. So CH3 CH double bond CH and CH2 CHO. So dipolar H cannot be reduced as olefinic fat, only it is reduced cyanide to aldehydes. Okay, so dipolar H is helpful to convert cyanide to aldehyde group, dipolar H. Similarly, esters are also converted into aldehydes, like this CH3CH2 taken 7 and COOC2H5. This is also important one. Now it is on treatment with dibol H, diisobutyl aluminium hydride. This ester group is converted into aldehyde. CH3, CH2 taken 7 and CHO, aldehydes. Okay, from nitriles or esters, cyanides converted to aldehydes in the presence of SNCl2 and HCl. This reaction is called as Stephens reaction. The cyanide is also reduced to aldehyde in the presence of dibol H, diisobutyl aluminium hydride. Here dibol H cyanide converted to aldehyde but not olefinic fat. That means dibol H cannot be reduced as alkenes, and esters are also converted into aldehydes in the presence of dibol H. Yes, and another one is preparation of aldehydes and ketones from alkyl benzenes or hydrocarbons. Alkyl benzenes or hydrocarbons. Okay, from alkyl benzene, from alkyl benzene or hydrocarbons, alkyl benzenes or hydrocarbons. Here methyl benzene, or it is also called as toluene. This methyl benzene on treatment with CrO2Cl2 chromyl chloride, CrO2Cl2 chromyl chloride, and followed by hydrolysis reaction, it gives benzaldehyde. This alkyl group is converted into aldehyde, chromyl chloride, or here ethyl benzene CH3CH2CH3, ethyl benzene with chromyl chloride CrO2Cl2, and followed by hydrolysis, only terminal carbon is converted into aldehyde. This is CH2CHO, aldehyde formation. This reaction is called as Etard's reaction. Etard's reaction. Okay, chromyl chloride hydrolysis. This reaction is also carried out in the presence of CrO3 by pyridine, is also same reaction, but it is not a Etard's reaction. Yes, toluene on treatment with chromyl chloride and followed by hydrolysis, we are getting benzaldehyde. And ethyl benzene with chromyl chloride, only terminal carbon is reduced to aldehyde group. So aldehydes are obtained in this reaction. Okay, this is the preparation methods. These are the preparation methods of aldehydes and ketones.